What's up, guys? Chase from Chase's Workshop here. This is going to be part three of how to build a guitar pickup. In the last video, we got to the point of we just had the bobbin. And in this video, we're going to get to this point. We've got everything done to this except for potting it. And we're going to pot it in the last video. I made a few mistakes, and I didn't edit them out. So maybe you'll get a good laugh out of my mistakes. Anyways, we're going to be using this pickup winder that I showed you guys how to build in my first ever YouTube video. Like I said, if you don't have a pickup winder and you want to build one, I built this one for under $50. So if you're interested, go check that out. If you have any comments, leave them below. If you like it, I'd really appreciate it if you subscribe. Thanks for watching, guys. All right, guys. Before we get to winding the pickup, I wanted to go over the journal that I talked to you about in the first video. And, you know, this was the one I used when I did the last two pickups. And I've kind of just broke down and got me another book to where I could write, I could keep it in a better book than just having it on this. And what I did was, is the last two pickups I did, the Telenetic, I put 8,000 wraps on it, and you know, ohmed it out, and it gave me a 5.8K resistance for that one. And then when I did my Tele Bridge pickup, I did 9,750 wraps, and that gave me a 7.66K resistance. And so I did the math on that, took the averages, and figured out between 1,250 to 1,300 per 1K wraps to get 1K out of that 42 gauge Timco wire. And that's what I was saying on this was, is to make sure you document everything, even document the wire that you've used and the characteristics of it and stuff like that. And as far as naming this one, I just put this down here for now. This is the date. So I'm going to put that on here. Maybe I might change it in the future, but I've put, you know, the name of the pickup, what kind of pickup it is. It's a Telenetic pickup. I'm going to wrap it clockwise. I'm going to use Alnico 5. We used Alnico 5 pole pieces, and I'm using Timco 42 gauge wire to wrap it. All right, so since we're going to be spinning clockwise, and that's going to, spin this way here. So I need to look at these bobbins to see which one I need to go into to start with. So if I'm going clockwise, it's going to be spinning this way. So if I hook in this one, the wire is going to be starting here and going around. And you can see where that could be. You could get that wrong. If you start here and you do clockwise, this wire is going to cross this bobbin, this eyelet right here. That's got our bobbin on there pretty good. So I'm going to be very careful. I don't know if you can see the wire or not, but it is like, it's hair thin. And it gets hung on everything if you ain't careful. Now I'm going to take my wire and I'm going to set it in the floor here. Right between my legs. Flange collars. Collar bearing collars, whatever they're called. All they are is with my guide. So as I'm winding the pickup, I have a guide to go by. But I want to set these to where when it's going, that I want it to be, I don't want it to catch anything but the side of the I don't want it to catch this out of the pickup. So we're going to test this out here just by hand driving it. And as you can see, it's pretty close on this side. I think it'll work. And I reset my counter here so that it's set to zero and everything's ready to go. And I'm just going to put, you know, 10 or 12 wraps on it. Okay, I think that's pretty good. I've got about 12 wraps on it now. Alright, so here we go. I'm going to make sure it's cut all the way down. And I'm going to make sure I'm flipped to the right position on my... Don't want to go clockwise. And I'm just going to slowly start it up. Start out kind of slow here. Check it, make sure everything still looks good. Not staying consistent at all. Still looking pretty good. As you can see, the buildup on these, so now I know I need to come on down here a little bit and stay down here some more. About 2800 right now. As you can tell, I'm kind of getting more at the bottom than I'm at the top, so I'm going to try to start putting more up here to kind of even it out a little bit. But that's why I say stop every so often and check and see what you got. I'm right at 5,086 wraps right now. So and that happened. Okay, hopefully a disaster was averted, but as you can see, I'm not an expert at winding pickups, but I'm trying, so. Okay, let's unpause our thing here, and let's get back to where we were. Start it up. So we're at 5,200 wraps right now. So I think I'm going to stop there. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take some of this tape and wrap it and see if I can make it some of these windings that kind of caught up here. I pulled them down and they're kind of loose. I don't want them to be loose on here. I want to tape them up and then we're going to pot it. So hopefully that'll fix it, make it sound okay, I guess. But like I said, I'm no expert at building these things, but like I said, practice makes perfect, or practice makes progress, I should say. But maybe you can learn a few things from some of my mistakes. But anyways, okay. So, but I'm gonna solder two wires into here, and that way we can get a see what our resistance is with a meter. So I'll be back. Okay, so now I've got my two wires, and I'm gonna start at my where I started at. So I started in this one right here as the start for my coil. I'm just gonna stick my wire through here, and I'm gonna get my soldering iron, which is I guess it's Weller PES51. Go ahead and clean my tip. So this piece right here will actually go, once I get this on here, it'll actually go back and solder to that, so we'll have a good ground. Okay, this pickup here was the last one that I did, and this one has 8,000 windings on it, and so we're going to get a... How many ohms it's got? It's got 5.51, somewhere in there. And this is the one we just wound, and we put 80. What do we put up on? End up putting on that one 8200 wraps or windings. We have 5.9. Okay, so now we've got to charge the magnet, and I already charged it a while ago to a south polarity. So you can see, closer I get to it, pull south. I think this thing's a little bit off kilter or something. Go this way, it'd be the north. So we got south. Alright, I want it north. So I'll take my two magnets, and I'm going to put north facing away, which I got a little N written on this magnet here. So I'm going to put north here. Take my other N right here and put it on the back side of it. And like I said earlier, this Will's Easy Guitar can go over this a lot more in depth than I do. So, and then all I do is I just take it and just move it back and forth between these two. I need to build some type of jig or something, but this actually works pretty good. So, all right, now let's see if we're still south polarity or not, if we've changed it to north. So now we're north. So we were south, and now we're north. Okay, I made a executive decision here. I decided to take that tape off at least the bottom portion of it, because I want, once this thing is, once I've got the cap on it here and I pot it, I want the wax to be able to hold all this together really well. And I think it'd get through that tape, but I think it'd be better not to have it. So I just kind of wrapped the spot that I messed up here on the top where I had the wires that caught the top of the lip here. Because when I pushed them off of there, they were kind of loose. So I'm just going to leave those on there. And, you know, I drill these holes in these pickups to where they will wax, be able to get down in there and pot everything well. So... I'm gonna try to figure out a way. Maybe I can bend these over, and I'll come back once I get that done. All right, guys. On this back part here that I was talking about in the last little section is, I eventually took a pair of channel locks and just held down real tight on the sides right here, and then took a hammer and beat these little tabs down. And it worked really well. All right, guys, that's about it for this video. If you have any comments or any questions, just leave them below. If you have any ideas to make my process better, leave them in the comments or send me an email or however you want to. If you like the video, I'd really appreciate it if you subscribe. So until the next video, we're going to be going over how to pot this pickup. So hope you stick around, and thanks for watching, guys.